Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Turntables and positioners help you increase the effective range of motion of your robot. Let's see how you can create your own custom one inside RoboDK. Let's get started. Let's open the online library once again, and under type, you can find external axis. Here you will find a bunch of positioner and turntables and a bunch of linear rails that you can use. So those are very useful if you want to create a small, quick demo or simulation without creating the whole custom mechanism yourself, or if you find exactly the one you're looking for here. So let's start by downloading one of these. So the IRB A250, and let's select the a simple here KUKA KP1 800. So I'm going to start with this one here. So this one is a simple positioner or turntable, in this case a positioner because it's on the side, and it can rotate between -180 and 90 degrees, 280 and 90 degrees. So it can rotate like that. If I was to attach a part to this positioner here, the part would follow, obviously. If I close this one, if I open the other one I downloaded, here this is a positioner, but this time you have two relative axes, so you can move the bed around like this, and then here you can move the final plate around its z-axis. So you can create those two kinds of mechanisms inside RoboDK. If you go to utilities, model mechanisms and robot, you can either do one rotative axis or you can do two rotative axis. We won't cover this one in terms of creating your own axis, as it's a bit too complicated for what we want to cover here. I will potentially cover that in a more advanced tutorial, but for now we'll stick to the simple one rotative axis. So I'm going to click cancel here, and I'm going to delete this one here. I will open under our basic mechanism folder, the turntable folder, and I have here turntable base and turntable top. So if I bring that here, I will have here the two pieces of my turntable. And if I look at my utilities, model mechanisms and robot, and then one rotative axis, if I bring that a bit bigger, you will see that the FB or frame base must be at the center of rotation. So I will go tools and then measure. I will measure the center point here. As you can see here, as it's not a very, let's say standard flat surface, there's hole everywhere. The center point is not right. So I'm gonna go here instead to snap on arc center. This one is more consistent. I'm gonna go copy. I needed to make sure that my absolute was activated. It doesn't change anything in this case because my part is where the original decision is. Don't forget about the absolute here. So I'm gonna make sure to first of all clear the selection and then reselect because I had both. I don't want to get misunderstand which one is which one. I'm gonna create a new frame. Let's call it frame base. Double click on it and let's apply the position here. So the frame here looks pretty much like the frame we have here, so that's great. So let's call this one turn table. Select the frame base. The base will be the bottom section here, and the joint one will be the top plate here rotating. Here for the minimum and maximum limit, depending if you have one that is created for welding, there's generally a ground in the place. That means that you have a limit number of turns you can process in one side, in one direction or the other. Otherwise, the cable would get entangled in, inside the mechanism. If you have one that is free and you have as many rotation as you can, you can just enter a very high value here. So either the real limits or a very high value. I'll go for -520, let's say, and I'll go and I'll click update. Here I have the copy of my 3D models, so I'm going to make those invisible. I'll close this here. And now I have a turntable that do rotate on its axis. So I can show and hide the flange, the frame here, and the turntable frame. I need to add a frame on top of it, right click, reset, put it in the middle, call it part. And if I was to click OK here, if I was to add a part on top of this turntable here, so let's just go get an object here, doesn't matter, object Earth, let's say, and place it on top here. I'm gonna move it up, just like that, let's say. If I was to rotate that like this, as you can see, it does rotate with the turntable as we were expecting. So that's pretty much it on how to create the turntable. Then you can create some positions the same way. So let's go for minus 520. I will create the first target here. And I don't know, like something around zero, create another target. Let's select the right frame, create another target. Target one, target two. And I will select both of those, right click, create program. Make sure that those are both joint motion. Otherwise you will have some weird behavior. So here, so I'm running to minus 160 to 91. I thought I went for minus 520 though. So right click, teach current position. Just to make sure here, and here options. Here. That's weird. It doesn't want to rotate here, let's see. Okay, now it works. I'm not so sure why it didn't register the minus 520 and it was stopping at 160. It's kind of like there was one turn missing. But anyway, now it works the way I would expect it to work. If I move, let's say here, right click, teach current position, run like that. That's perfect. Okay, so that's great. That's pretty much everything for this video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we'll talk about part feeder a bit. So how you can create a simple part feeder that will bring part forever, or in fact will bring up or forward a stack of part. And that will conclude how to create the different mechanisms. Then we'll have a few videos on how to use them in a real situation, so you can better understand the concept of having some programs that are specifically for the mechanisms and some programs that are specifically for the robot. Okay, that being said, have a great day, guys.